Presidential congratulations for the Mars Perseverance rover team. The rover makes its first drive on the red planet and a pair of spacewalks outside the space station. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. On March 4th, President Joe Biden made a congratulatory call to our Jet Propulsion Laboratory's Center Director Mike Watkins and the entire Mars 2020 team for the successful February 18th landing on the red planet of our Perseverance rover.
You guys did it. You guys gave a sense of America's back. It's astounding what you did. You believed in science. You believed in hard work, and you believed it wasn't a darn thing you couldn't do if you put your minds together.
Perseverance also made its first drive on Mars March 4th, a trek across the Martian landscape that covered about 21.3 feet and which also served as a mobility test. Once the rover begins pursuing its science goals, it is expected to clock drives of 665 feet or more. Meanwhile, mission team scientists have informally named the rover's landing site Octavia E. Butler Landing in honor of the groundbreaking author and Pasadena, California native, who was the first African-American woman to win both the Hugo Award and Nebula Award, and was the first science fiction writer honored with a MacArthur Fellowship. Astronauts conducted a pair of spacewalks outside the International Space Station during the week. On February 28th, our Kate Rubens and Victor Glover completed a 7-hour, 4-minute spacewalk to begin installing modification kits needed for solar array upgrades later this year. Once installed, the new solar arrays will increase the station's total available power. 5 days later, Rubens and Japan's Soichi Noguchi ventured outside to complete the installation of the modification kits and to tackle additional work, including the venting of ammonia from the station's thermal control system. NASA's SpaceX Crew 2 mission, targeted for launch no earlier than mid-April, will be the second crew rotation flight of a U.S. commercial spacecraft with astronauts to the space station. The Crew 2 astronauts, Shane Kimbrough and Megan MacArthur of NASA, Akihiko Hoshide of the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, and European Space Agency astronaut Thomas Pesquet talked about the mission during a virtual crew news conference on March 1st.
I'm looking forward to flying with this great crew that you see on the screen. It's been the first time in over 20 years that a crew from NASA, ESA, and JAXA have flown together, so that's pretty cool too. We're looking forward to spending several months on the International Space Station.
Our James Webb Space Telescope passed two important milestone tests in February, moving the observatory a step closer to being ready for launch in October. Engineers confirmed Webb's internal electronics are working as intended and that the spacecraft and its four scientific instruments can send and receive data through the same network they will use in space. Webb will solve mysteries in our solar system, look to distant worlds around other stars, and investigate the origins of our universe and our place in it. In celebration of Women's History Month, we have updated our annual feature recognizing the most recent women who have conducted science aboard the International Space Station. It's available online at go.nasa.gov/women-in-space. The women featured are among the 65 women overall as of March 2021 who have flown in space as cosmonauts, astronauts, payload specialists, and space station participants. The next phase of testing in our Advanced Air Mobility National Campaign this month uses a helicopter as a stand-in advanced air mobility vehicle flying various maneuvers at our Armstrong Flight Research Center in California. NASA and the Federal Aviation Administration are working together to create a new air transportation system that could support passenger and cargo transportation in urban, suburban, rural, and regional environments. Data from these flights will be used to help develop operational procedures for that new system. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.